ॐ श्री महालक्ष्मी तुभ्यं नमः। हेलो एवरीबॉडी, एज वी ऑल नो वरमहालक्ष्मी फेस्टिवल इज वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट फेस्टिवल्स इन साउथ इंडिया एंड एस्पेशली फॉर द पीपल ऑफ कर्नाटका। महालक्ष्मी कैन बी इक्वेटेड टू परब्रह्म। शी इज द एम्बॉडीमेंट ऑफ हेल्थ, हैप्पीनेस, वेल्थ एंड प्रॉस्पेरिटी। शी इज द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द अष्टलक्ष्मीज, आदिलक्ष्मी हुम वी प्रे फॉर द गुड स्टार्ट, धैर्य लक्ष्मी हु इज अ डिस्ट्रॉयर ऑफ ईविल, धान्य लक्ष्मी हु इज अ गिवर ऑफ फूड एंड न्यूट्रिशन, धनलक्ष्मी हु इज द गिवर ऑफ वेल्थ, विद्यालक्ष्मी हु इज द गिवर ऑफ नॉलेज, विजय लक्ष्मी हु इज द गिवर ऑफ विक्टरी एंड सक्सेस, संतान लक्ष्मी हु इज द गिवर ऑफ चिल्ड्रन एज वेल एज द चाइल्ड्स गुड हेल्थ एंड प्रॉस्पेरिटी, एंड गजलक्ष्मी who is the destroyer of all the problems and sorrows in life. So today we are going to celebrate the Varmahalakshmi festival by doing a drawing and painting on the basis of this topic. Hello everyone. So we all know that this drawing is the one which we are going to go by. It's a new theme. It is based on a rangoli and Shri Lakshmi's feet and the kalasha which is worshipped by many of us here. So this is going to be a new type of drawing. We will be using poster colors. So I hope all of you have drawn this on the colored sheet. You were asked to draw it on a dark color sheet. I hope all of you have drawn it. Some of you find it difficult to draw. You can always trace. So we can use this kind of yellow carbon for tracing. You know that. So you should keep this surface to the colored sheet and then keep this on top and then seal it with cello tape so that the thing does not move. And then just go over these lines with the pencil so that the impression of the yellow carbon comes to the colored sheet. Here, as you all know, we have already started with some of the gold. See, I hope you can see how beautiful it looks. So the rest of the painting we will be completing now. I hope you are ready with it, ready with all the materials. We are going to be using poster colors. I have already informed you all the materials. I hope you all have them ready. So you can do it along with me. Okay? So this is the main kalasha and the coconut. Let us start the coconut with its natural color. That is, we will be making a lighter shade of brown. Everyone knows so first while you are trying to mix colors you need to put the lighter color and to that you have to add some of the darker color little by little going to add little bit of white to brown. Just a minute. Thank you. Sorry for the little interruption. Anyway, I hope you have made all your preparations ready. Is your color ready? Have you mixed it for getting a light brown? Okay. Now, with a thin brush, thin round brush. Okay, we should make it lighter. Some of you have not yet got it very light. Please add some more white. Okay, see, because the surface is already colored, we must think about how the look is going to be. So as you all know, first outline. You can all see the line of the tracing which you have done, right? So just outline it and then fill up with the color. This will give you a subtle effect. Okay, because the background is already colored, we are just looking for a subtle effect.
Children, please be careful when you do this and don't make it come on the idle.
See, again, it should be like the hairs of the coconut. See here. Coconut will have some fibers, no? We are trying to do it like that. This is just a very subtle color difference it will be. But in the end, you will have a nice painting. Okay? The same way, this light shade of brown, let us put for the lamp also. Always we prefer to use earthen lamps because they are eco-friendly. Okay, we should always try to be eco-friendly during these festivals. Are you all doing it with me? See, we get a nice shade here. It is subtle and elegant. Yeah, yeah. You can use other dark colors also, but make sure the combination looks good. Yeah, you may need to put a little bit thicker color because some might get absorbed. I am using poster colors. Yeah, make sure you color within the outlines. Next, Michelle. Go for the rangoli parts. Now naturally rangoli is usually basically white. On that we put some colors sometimes. So first we will start with the white parts. Please use a very thin brush and make sure the white is bright and clean. Now, all these lines we must do with white. Yeah, don't use watery color.
let it be little thick only.
See, like this. Neat thin lines.
Try your best to draw thin lines. First, before this, you have to practice drawing thin lines as we have shown you in the video.
Can you all see the thin lines?
This side also do it similarly. Have you all drawn? Now we have to draw this ground line.
We have drawn this line in perspective.
Please be continuous as much as possible. Now we will be drawing an outline for the lotus petals in white.
See, for the rangoli, it always looks very nice to have bright colors.
Generally, we are drawing 8 corners, so 8 petals are drawn. There is also a star. Inside the star, there is the feet of Goddess Lakshmi. Just the feet are drawn. All the 5 toes and the feet.
Do you all know what that represents? Can anyone tell me?
It represents the feet of Goddess Lakshmi. And the lotus, she is always associated with the lotus. She is holding the two lotus as well as she is standing or sitting on a lotus. So
it shows that Lakshmi will come to us and bless us, that she will visit our homes. Yeah, be slow and neat when you do this.
Now we are working on the gold. Generally we are using poster color gold or Fevicryl acrylic gold. This is actually a mixed media painting if you use the acrylic. Otherwise, if you find the poster color gold, it will be a poster color painting.
So I am keeping the toes. One was already there. Another 5. Another 4. Totally it should be 5. Now don't add watery color. Use thick color only.
The outline of the kalasham. Preferably a thick line of gold will show the line of the kalasham.
Are you all managing to do along with me?
You can take the thing directly from the bottle so that you can get better effect. Next to the rangoli, we are decorating with gold coins or gold colored coins.
So in between these petal designs, you can just fill in some of the gold. Yeah, go neatly, like the same shape, so that it looks neat. Okay, so now I hope it is clear to all of you. It is. So we have done the kalasham and now we are going to put light green for all the leaf parts. I am going to add yellow color to green to get a very light shade of green. You must keep in mind that we are working on a colored surface. In accordance to that, we are going to use a light green. Make adequate color by mixing green with yellow. Yeah, you can use sap green or light green or even poster green. See, this is the color which has been made. Now here are the leaves used to decorate the kalasha. Neatly fill it up. First I shall fill one side. See, first you draw the neat outline and fill it up. Yeah, little bit shade variation will look nice. Don't need of any drastic variations, just a subtle variation. So draw the outline. I'm still using my thin round brush only. Even around the Rangoli, we have got such leaf decorations. So, each of them let us color with light green.
If the coat is too watery, please add some more color and fill up the leaves.
After this, we will add, we have to make pink to put for the lotuses as well as in the Rangoli. So I am sure you all know how to make pink. Pink is made with first adding white and then to that little by little adding red. So just a little red to the white. Don't add too much.
We'll give an outline first. See, with this effect, by working on a colored paper, we get a very subtle but beautiful effect. Yeah, I'm just giving outlines. After that, we will fill up with a different shading so that we get a appearance like a lotus leaf. Lotus petal, sorry. Here also let us put for some parts this pink shade. Now let us make a little more light shade of pink to give the shades. Actually, lighter shades are called tints. So you can say that we are using a light tint of red. See now? In the other part, we will put it here and just merge it a bit. So we get a nice effect of real petals. Does anyone have any doubts? Yeah, now we are using the lighter shade of pink. Lighter tint, you can also say. So can you all see this? I hope it is clearly visible. Now we will fill in the rangoli part. See, I'm just filling in the direction of these petals. Then it looks more realistic. Just merge it up with one dot of water.
Children, if you can, you draw with us. Otherwise, you can send it on the WhatsApp. You can complete it and send it on the WhatsApp.
See, we have almost finished these rangoli petals. Can someone tell me what is left to do now? Yes, now we will do the flame of these lamps. For that we will be choosing yellow. Just put a yellow over here. See, it gives you a bright look. I'm outlining with light orange. For this part of the lamp, where we will usually have the oil, I'm right now just filling some sort of orangish color. Okay, everyone. So now the painting is finally ready. So I hope everyone could do it along with me and completed it. So now the gold is completely shining and Goddess Lakshmi is looking very beautiful. I've also decorated with the dots made up of golden color. Hope you all like the effect. Let us have a blessed Varamahalakshmi festival. Let us remember Purandara Dasa's
श्री पुरंदर दास देवर नाम भाग्यद लक्ष्मी बारम्म थैंक यू ऑल डू शेयर योर फिनिश्ड वर्क्स विथ अस यू वुड बी रियली हैप्पी टू सी दैट ओके सी यू अगेन थैंक यू ऑल